Ezekiel Elliott is still not in camp, but we got a little more insight on his future yesterday. Reps for Zeke told the Cowboys that he will not play this season without a new contract, according to ESPN. And Stephen Jones said yesterday that the market was reset by Le'Veon Bell's deal with the Jets. This could be a problem for Zeke, since Le'Veon is making just over $13 million a year, and Zeke reportedly wants Todd Gurley money. He makes over $14 million a year. We're joined by Fox football analyst Reggie Bush. Good to have you with us, Reggie.
Good morning.
Good morning.
So you think Zeke will actually miss regular season games?
I think he could. I think he could miss regular season games because it's the only leverage that he has, right? In a situation where you have 2 years left on your contract, the team can franchise tag you up to 2 years. I understand his point. I do think he does deserve to be the highest paid because he is the best. And out of the three who have been offered from the Cowboys, top five money, Dak, Amari, and Zeke. Zeke is the only one that's actually top five in his position.
Top! Right?
He the only one.
Only one.
I can argue.
Amari. You can't argue nothing.
I can.
No, you can't.
I can argue.
Well, I'm like the NCAA. You need a law degree.
Dak and Amari, I don't even think they're top 10 in their positions. So, Zeke does have some leverage, but the only leverage is holding out and not playing, and withholding services and not playing games. I think running backs are now starting to understand more the shelf life of a running back, understanding that I have a small window of opportunity to make the most money possible. I understood it when I played. I think guys are looking at Le'Veon Bell's situation and saying, well, he held out a year to get the money that he wanted. Now, I was a little bothered because he didn't get more than Todd Gurley.
Right, right.
You held out all that time, and you didn't get more than Todd Gurley. And so now you reset, Stephen Jones said.
I think his market dried up, Le'Veon.
Yeah.
It did.
I think so.
I think the Jets gave him more than they needed to give him. They're bidding against themselves.
And so teams are now probably looking at Todd Gurley and saying, well, we gave another case of a situation where we gave running back money, and now we're asking the question, how many reps should we give him because he's been injured and banged up?
Before you go, how long did you last? How many years was it?
11.
You played 11?
11 years.
Pretty good.
Yeah.
Your biggest contracts came where and where?
So thank God, thanks to my mom, I was born in a time where they were still giving players the money up front.
The old money up front. And you were the second.
And I was the second pick. And so I think Zeke understands now that I got to get this money now.
So you got big contract up first front, and then front. Nothing like it thereafter.
Nothing like that afterwards.
Okay.
Nothing like that afterwards. So it's different because now running backs have to prove themselves in those first couple years. And so it's much different than when I came out. And so I think Zeke is seeing this and saying, well, I deserve to be highest paid, which he does, but he doesn't have a ton of leverage right now in this situation. So it's going to be interesting to see how it plays out, but I do think he'll miss games.
Yeah, he has to. And as Reggie mentioned, the only leverage that he's ever had, the only leverage any player has is withholding his services, is the holdout skip. That's the only leverage he has. And if you look at this, if you had a draft right now, you says, okay, Zeke, Dak, and Amari, which one of those guys you think, all 32 teams, which one do you think going off the board first? Out of Dak Prescott, Zeke Elliott, and Amari Cooper?
You might be surprised, because I think it would be Dak Prescott.
I guarantee you,
it depends on needs.
I believe Saquon right now, I believe Saquon Barkley is the best running back in football. But Zeke is a top three, top four back.
Oh, now he's falling all the way to four.
No. But hold on. But your quarterback is not top 15. He might be top 15. I might can sneak him in, Skip. If you speak highly to me, because me and you good friends, and normally your friends are my friends, I can get him into the top 15. But Cooper's not a top 10 wide receiver.
No.
He's not going in front of Julio, A.B., D-Hop, Mike Evans, Mike Thomas, Adams, Thielen, A.J. Green, or Mike Evans. Maybe, okay, Juju.
Tyreek Hill.
Tyreek. So I'm just saying that right there, Skip. I believe in order of importance, I would go Zeke, Amari, Dak for the simple facts. Look, Jerry, I don't believe that they believe that Dak is the guy. You say they say that they that. Now, Jerry says he's a franchise quarterback and we can win multiple Super Bowls. But him stalling him out tells me I'm uncertain. Philadelphia Eagles had no resurrection. Man, go give a walker to him that money. $108 million guaranteed, like it ain't nothing. And your guy hasn't missed a start. my guy has missed like what, 7-8 games?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That just goes to show you, Skip Bayless. And
who's the leader of the Dallas Cowboys?
The same guy that's the leader of the Philadelphia Eagles.
Oh, really? The guy who had the big expose written on him by Philly Voice. Remember that?
Leadership there.
A whole big expose about what a terrible leader he has been behind the scenes.
Yeah. I just want to say,
really?
Skip, this is my last point. The thing that Zeke has working in his favor is that he and Todd were the same age, 24. Mm-hmm. Le'Veon is 3 years older, and he has 1,500 touches already on his body.
Mm-hmm.
So Zeke knows the likelihood of you're going to get one contract. You're going to get one big contract.
That's it.
Dak Prescott's going to get another big contract. Skip, he doesn't have to be spectacular, but he'll get another big contract if he's just mediocre to slightly above.
Mm-hmm.
Amari Cooper can get another contract.
Mm-hmm.
Zeke Elliott is never, ever going to get another big contract after this one. Mm. That's fact.
Mm. So Zeke obviously has outperformed his first contract.
Yeah.
Can he outperform another one? Probably not.
No.
Okay?
No.
Jerry Jones has to keep that in mind, right?
Right.
Oh, it's in his mind. He know.
Okay. So back to young Mr. Bush here.
Yeah.
I like his ensemble today.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
I did not like his opening. I do not believe that Ezekiel Elliott will miss a real football game. First of all, Jerry also knows what Zeke is made of. What is his psyche? He loves to practice football, and he obviously loves to play football games, especially when they count.
Mm-hmm.
So I think he is dearly missing camp practices because he likes to be with the fellas in the locker room. He likes to kid. He likes to prank. He just likes to be in that atmosphere because it's what he knows and loves the most about life.
And that's what he's done for half his life. Yeah. And this time of year, been around football, football players.
These days start passing just terribly slowly. They go slower and slower, especially when you're by yourself in Cabo. Not that he didn't have people with him, but you just feel like you're on permanent vacation in Cabo. It's a nice place for 5 or 6 days.
Yeah.
And then the seventh day, you start to say, God, it's kind of boring around here. Not that much going on. Am I going to go work out by myself again? Am I going to do it again? We haven't even played one preseason game yet, and they have four scheduled.
Mm-hmm.
So the only week that matters to me is the week after Labor Day, building up to September 8th opener.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
So for me, wake me up on Labor Day. I will start getting anxious on Labor Day because that's all they need from Zeke, because they don't really need him in camp anyway.
Yeah.
Why risk him going out there in some goal line drill and
that's
having
true.
Some freak injury?
I agree
don't know.
With that.
I hate that. It's like my biggest pet peeve about sports is a training camp injury.
Yeah.
So the point is, Jerry knows his psyche. He'll get Dak done. I don't even know if he'll get Amari done next, but the tricky one is the Zeke one.
Yeah.
Because Zeke has by far the least leverage.
Mm-hmm.
So if he wants to stay in Cabo, he could stay for 4 more years because Jerry's got him. But seriously,
right,
does Jerry not have him?
He does.
By a CBA, he's got him for 4 more years.
I think the thing that also knows Zeke has leverage because he said if you didn't think I was valuable, you'd have never taken me with the 4th overall pick.
Right.
That told me. Now, you told me what you thought about Dak because you took him in the 4th round.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you did trade for Amari, gave up a 1st round pick, but that was in the 20s.
Yeah.
See, you told me my value. You told me what you needed.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to say it one more time. Ezekiel Elliott is the best running back in football.
Yeah, I agree with that.
No, Saquon is.
The running back position is not the most important.
No.
The quarterback position is. And my quarterback took off when they traded for Amari Cooper because you need somebody you trust.
Yes.
He trusted nobody. The first 8 games last year with Zeke, healthy and happy, they went 3-5.
Mm-hmm.
And guess who the number one receiver was in many of those games? It was Zeke.
Right. Yeah.
Because he didn't trust anybody.
Yeah.
He didn't have a number one.
Yeah.
All of a sudden, Amari walks in the door, and not only does the quarterback take off, but so does the receiver, who was terribly unhappy in Oakland.
Because
they clicked.
Yes. Okay? He took off because of Zeke, though, because Zeke opens it up for the pass game, not the other way around.
No.
Zeke makes Dak better. Dak does not make Zeke
better. It's still a passing game.
Yeah.
It's a passing game.
And I agree with you.
Wait a second. I made the case to you the other day. You're way underestimating Julian Edelman's value because, to me, he's a top 5 producer. Not if we do a combine, he's like top 35.
In New England.
Right?
That's true with Tom Brady.
That's what I'm saying.
In New England, who's throwing the football.
Amari with Dak Prescott in Dallas.
They're not getting that same production, though.
Well, they will. I don't know. They went 7-1 down the stretch when he walked in the door. I don't know.
You're right. The quarterback is the most valuable position.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. But if you build your team around the running game mm-hmm. first,
yeah.
now you've added value to the running back. Okay. And Zeke knows that.
When did your eyes tell you the last 8 games last year?
That Zeke was a monster.
And they had a real good defense. Mm. A real
Dak Prescott,
defense.
Over the last 8 games, had the 3rd most completions mm-hmm. in football, the 4th most passing yards, mm-hmm. and the 5th what's called air distance, like how far did the pass travel? Yeah. So he wasn't dinking and dacking when he got Amari.
Yeah, he was. Okay? Because guess what?
Top 5. Those are top 5 stats.
Hold on. Did you notice that over the last 8 games, when he got Amari Cooper, that Zeke Elliott had 55 receptions? Mm-hmm. Now, was Zeke catching go routes? Was he mm-hmm. catching bang 8s? Mm-hmm. No. Check down, screens, dump downs. That's what he was catching, Skip Bayless. Mm-hmm. So this notion.
What did he catch against Detroit to beat the Lions in game number 3?
Thank you. You know what?
What was it?
He said, Jerry. See, Jerry, you see my value? Mm. I can get down the field and catch the ball. Mm. Thank you, Skip. I'm glad you brought that up. I forgot that Zeke could catch the ball down the field.
He was Amari Cooper for a while.
Yeah.
I was at the Thursday night game where they beat the New Orleans Saints. Mm-hmm. Dak played terrible that game.
Thank you very much. Dak had a QBR. Do you know QBR? It's scaled 0 to 100. He had a 72 that game, which is really good.
He didn't tell the story.
And wait a second. What's the other quarterback's name? Oh, yeah. Drew Brees had a 15.
The defense won them that game.
Dak's completed like 24 of 28. I got it here somewhere. Here it is. Wait. He's 24 of 28 for 249, 1 touchdown, and no interceptions. And that's terrible?
And he also almost cost him the game at the end where he turned it over.
He had a fumble trying to do too much in the red zone.
Oh, so I got to deduct this, Skip. Okay. You know, Jerry's thinking about that, saying you try to do too much. Mm. When we put it on your plate, Skip, stop.
That was a defensive game.
The man scored 13 points.
Okay, but
how you score 13 points if you go 24-28 with 1 touchdown? Mm. How you only get 13 points?
I don't know.
I know. Yeah. I know when you're dinking and dunking.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Wait, for 249? That's
check down
good.
Charlie.
Oh, that's pretty good.
Dak is
interesting.
Dak is a 1-2 touchdown kind of quarterback. Mm. I think that
you know what he is? He's a 4th quarter kind of comeback quarterback.
He's a 200-yard quarterback.
He led this league in 4th quarter comebacks, mm-hmm. game-winning drives over the last 3 years, and this past year he had 6 of them.
1960s, 70s, 200-yard, 180, 200-yard with a gold standard. Mm. That would have been elite.
Mm.
Now you need to be throwing for 300.
Yeah.
And he can't do that often enough.
Especially to get to the Super Bowl, you got to be able to push the ball down the field.
Down the field.
And we saw them get beat in the playoffs by a defense that was not playing good football all season.
Interesting, against the defending Super Bowl champ Eagles in the 4th quarter of the 2nd game at Jerry World. Dak Prescott in the 4th quarter in overtime threw for 243. Is that good?
I want you to have that same
17
energy.
To 20. 3 touchdowns and no interceptions.
I want you to have that.
But he can't throw a lick.
I want you
how
to
do he do that?
He only had 2 games. He only had 2 games all season last year where he threw over 2 touchdowns. Huh. He had 10 games where he had either 0 or 1 touchdown last year.
And he had 9 games when he had 200 yards or less. Huh. When did he do that?
Those all came early before he had Amari.
That sounds like another quarterback that played, that won the division, and won a playoff game, throwing for 200 and doing something big in the 4th quarter. I forget his name. What's his name, Skip?
Forget his name.
All he does is, you know, you came over and had a song about it. All he does is win, win, win.
Yeah. Oh, I didn't write it.
Oh, yeah, you gave that was you. That's all you do. All he does is win.
All he does is win. That won an award.
I think
that won the Webby that year.
The last point I want to make real quick that I think people are forgetting is that Kellen Moore, this is his first year calling plays.
Love it.
Fair.
Jerry Jones is putting a lot of trust and faith into a rookie play caller.
I'm good.
If this thing does not work out, because there's no guarantee this is going to work out. I played with Kellen Moore just a couple years ago.
I know.
So I thought he got the job kind of quick.
Woo.
So if this thing don't work out,
where you played
week
him in,
2, week 3,
you were was it
Detroit?
Detroit, yeah.
Detroit.
And you hope he called plays better than he played.
Hope he called,
Those
first 3 games are winnable.
Wait, do you have to be able to play quarterback to call plays?
Skip, I said, all
that is interesting.
All I said was I hope he called plays better than what he played.
Was Josh McDaniels an all-pro?
Oh, my God.
I don't remember.
Help me out.
Either way.
Was Gary Kubiak a great player?
Did you see, hold on. Did you see Josh McDaniels without Tom Brady? Mm. I remember he was the head coach in Denver, and I remember he was the offensive coordinator at the Rams.
Look good.
All I'm saying, that's all I know. I don't know anything else about Josh McDaniels. I don't know Josh McDaniels, the rest is so Wahoo McDaniels. Mm. Wahoo McDaniels played for the Broncos.
Yeah.
But anyway, Skip, stop it. So when you talk about Josh McDaniels, you got to put him in a vacuum. You got Tom Brady vacuum.
Mm-hmm. Kellen Moore is going to change life.